live from the heart and soul of Phoenix, welcome to the campus of Grand Canyon University, and inside GCU Orium, where tonight, Bryce Drew makes his coaching debut with the Lopes, hosting the Tigers from Grambling State. Good evening and welcome to GCU Basketball, alongside three-time NBA champion Scott Williams behind the glass. I'm Barry Butel. Kate Longworth will be along in just a moment. Well, here we are, Scott. By the grace of all things almighty, we are here to bring you GCU basketball, the powers of a number of people, but we are ready for basketball, and it couldn't come at a better time.
Yes, very thankful on this Thanksgiving Eve to be back here in GCU Arena doing some college basketball, because this team has got something to prove. I got Coach Bryce Drew has really got this team amped up, ready to take the floor.
Yeah, 14th head coach in GCU history, Bryce Drew taking the helm as head coach.
Yeah, passion. That's what this guy personifies out there on, and he wants that from his players as well. Wants them to be a smart bunch, but he wants them to play out there with a commitment on both sides of the basketball, value the ball offensively, and get after people defensively.
Well, one guy he knows he can count on is the big man, Alessandro Laver.
Yeah, he's a guy, an all-whack performer this year. First-team selection, can do it from the inside, can do it from the outside, has added about 15 pounds of muscle since we saw him 257 days ago.
Well, they take on a Grambling State team that was 17-15 a year ago, 11-7 in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. We'll talk more about the Tigers from Grambling State as we get things started. But now let's send it down to Paul DeNuzer with tonight's opening prayer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the beautiful GCU Arena for tonight's men's basketball matchup between the Tigers of Grambling State University and your Grand Canyon University Antelopes. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you all please rise if you are able. Gentlemen, please remove your caps as we begin this evening's competition with the word of prayer. Tonight's prayer is led by Joshua Gillespie, this year's Havocs president and a junior majoring in finance and economics.
Let's pray. Father, thank you for this evening, and thank you for the gifts that you've given us and that we can gather here tonight and honor you, Lord. And I pray for safety for all of the players, coaches, and officials involved. And God, I pray that you'd make this a great night of fun for all involved. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Joshua. And now let's meet the starting lineups for tonight's contest. First of all, for the Tigers of Grambling State University, at guard, a 6-foot senior, number 10, Travell Cunningham. At guard, a 6'6 senior, number 11, Kelton Edwards. At forward, a 6'8 senior, number 21, Terrion Randolph. At guard, a 6'7 senior, number 22, Prince Moss. And at forward, a 6'9 senior, number 30, Brian Thomas. The Tigers play in the Southwestern Athletic Conference. They're led by head coach Dante Jackson. Assistant coaches Winston Hines, Demetrius Moore, and Kyle Jones.
I'm not to tell you about GCU. We'll get back to Grambling State in just a moment. Bryce Drew is in his first season as head coach. Here is his starting lineup, brought to you by Talking Stick Resort. Javon Blackshear Jr., Sean Miller Moore, Oscar Freyer, Alessandro Laver, and Ashbjorn Midgard.
Yeah, the big Ashty. We're going to keep our eye on him this night. He's 270 pounds of raw steel down underneath the basket, throws his body around. He's going to be a space eater, a rim protector, and he's going to chew glass
That's what Coach Bryce has challenged him every night, and that's what the Lopes missed a year ago.
5 seasons at Valparaiso, 3 more at Vanderbilt, 3 trips to the NCAA tournament. This is 19th season overall as a head coach. Assistant coaches Jamal Walker, Ed Schilling, and Casey Shaw. Director of player development is Ryan Lightfoot. The director of recruiting is A.C. Moi'i Koibu. Director of video operations, Peyton Prudhomme. Strength and conditioning coach Jordan Jackson. The athletic trainer is Jordy Hackett. And the student athletic development director is Sean Pryor. As I mentioned, Grambling State, Dante Jackson, their head coach in his 4th season. Here is his starting five: Travell Cunningham, Kelton Edwards, Prince Moss, Terrion Randolph, and Brian Thomas.
Yeah, all of these guys. Don't sleep on this talented team right here. We had an opportunity to put our eyes on them. They are athletic and quick, like cats out there on the floor. GCU's going to have to protect that ball tonight, or they're going to be running back on defense, scrambling to try to catch up with these Tigers.
Let's get to our Sanderson Ford keys to the game. The best play on a new Ford is at Sanderson Ford.
Well, it's more the keys than all season long. You got to respect that, Rock. Value placed offensively, execution. Everyone's got to do their job. That means move with a purpose, set good strong, cut good and strong, set good screens, make good passes on time and on target. No unforced errors and a commitment to defend. Coach Drew's going to demand that his players out there on the floor don't give up easy paint scores. No uncontested three-point shots. Then they got to rebound the ball and finish off that defensive possession, and he wants to get out and run on misses. And then the last thing, all for one and one for all. Establish a team chemistry early in the season by playing for one another. You know, how do you do that? You cover for a teammate should he blow a defensive rotation. You make an extra pass on offense that leads to a better shot and a score. You encourage your teammate if he gets down. You build him back up.
Are you ready? Here we go. The Bryce Drew era underway here at Grand Canyon University. In possession, GCU. Javon Blackshear Jr. comes out, moves to his right, takes it back from Freyer. Labor to Mikey Dixon. Dixon to Freyer, looks inside, bounce pass to Ashbourne Midgard, back out, quick ball movement, Freyer, Labor, puts it down on the floor, drives, kicks back out, gets picked off, but it goes out of bounds. Prince Moss.
Yeah, they're quick, they're going to get their hands on a lot of balls out there. That particular play, it looked like Labor thought Javon Blackshear was going to float down to the corner, so there's a little miscommunication here, maybe just some opening jitters for the first 3 to 4 minutes of this basketball game.
8 on the shot clock. Blackshear looks in. Out to Dixon. Midgard, Labor. Back to Javon. 4-3 on the shot clock. Stops, pops. Good!
Well, that was nice right there. A little two-man basketball after they got the ball inbounds with Labor setting a nice screen. Javon Blackshear, who has improved his shooting, according to Bryce Drew, has been working hard in the lab, trying to get that stroke fine-tuned.
Grambling loses a handle there.
Oscar Freyer with the poke away, something he has done so many times. I think that just ties him for the lead in GCU history for steals.
Down low, right hand, doesn't drop, but Freyer's there.
Extra possessions, Freyer doing the little things to help his team.
Oh, look at this man, truck!
You nailed it, Barry. That was exactly what that was. Too big, too strong, too many kilos down there for the Tigers.
Whoops out to an early lead. Prince Moss drives, travel.
Look at the big fella. Labor really got over and slid his foot good. Now look at this one right here. Just a nice little spin move inside. Gathers himself, goes up with power, and puts it in with the left hand. Gotta like that. GCU up to a nice start.
Ronnie Hernandez, Matthew Ruckison, and LaVon Zakarian are the officials tonight. In the corner, Freyer. Off the mark. Pushed out by Labor. Look at the Twin Towers. That one doesn't happen. And the Tigers come up with the rebound. Here they come up the floor. Cunningham. Who's right? Oh, look at the defense by Blackshear on the run. Up top, swatted away. Good defensive play there by Terrion Randolph.
Yeah, Blackshear, he's going to give up a lot of size there. But look at Blackshear. Goes back and gets it again.
Off the glass with a kiss.
Oh,
They've gotten their hands on three or four times down the floor. They've gotten balls deflected or stolen, and I got everybody up off the bench and excited about that one. JBJ working hard defensively, gives it over to Mikey Dixon, who powers it right to the rack.
Lopes have forced four turnovers on this 6-0 start against Grambling State at GCU Arena.
Well, that's what you need. You need that commitment to the defensive side of the ball. Lopes did not have that last year. A couple years ago, back in 2017, when they faced this Grambling State Tigers team, they put together a series of games, four games, where they held their opponent under 60 points. Grambling State was one of those victims, scoring only 57 points, got blown out by 32. Lopes tried to do that same sort of thing again, put a heavy pressure on this Tigers team defensively.
Well, Cunningham walking things off. The senior from Chicago, Illinois came up, hobbled. Blackshear allowed, jumped in on that opportunity and stole the ball away. Prince Moss back up. Randall, near side. Peyton Taylor. And the Grambling Tigers on the board, Kelton Edwards.
Yeah, nice shot by that young man. He put a little two-piece move that time on Mikey Dixon. It was good defense, just better offense. Look at this little three-quarter court press here. Get the steal.
Telegraph that one. Takes it all the way to the bucket. Terrion Randall.
Yeah, that timeout really worked well for them. They were able to get the score. Now they've gotten a stop to get right back to their trap once again.
Blackshear looks left. Frayer quickly. Turnaround. Labor. A little bit of hand, but he follows up with the bucket.
Yeah, they went like a, once they got the ball into the scoring area, that half-court zone defense had a lot of holes on it, and they found Labor right down there on that left block.
Randall near side, Peyton Taylor. Taylor drives. Little floater high off the glass, doesn't happen. Frayer able to keep it in.
And Frayer, he gets the play of everything. It steals, rebounds the ball on defensive end, the offensive end, shoots the threes.
How about that, Mikey Dixon?
Mikey Dixon, he's looking for a shot from behind the arc. One for two now from behind the arc, shooting that three ball.
Taylor. Randall. Not by Labor. Coming out is Thomas. Near side up. Edwards. Beyond the arc. A little heavy. A little battle there between the Twin Towers.
Yeah, I like the way the big Ashty went out there and claimed that basketball.
Floater doesn't go for Blackshear.
You know, he's not a stiff. He rebounded that ball outside of his position. Yeah, you know, sometimes you hear about a guy 270, you wonder how he's going to be able to move. He's shown some good mobility in the early part of this game.
Lopes on the court, have a bucket.
We've got legs like tree trunks down there battling with big number 30. Neat. Wow.
Move on Labor. Doesn't go. Midgard with the rebound.
Midgard doing a nice job blocking out on that weak side. Long shots, long rebounds, and he had that whole side of the basket covered. Shoots it from three.
Oh, probably ill-advised.
Oh, Javon Blackshear took one of the chops. He's all right.
Lopes have the rebounding margin 7-3. Timeout on the floor, 15-13 to go. How about Mikey Dixon?
Yeah, if you're gonna run and get open looks, you got to rebound the basketball, push it down the floor. Javon Blackshear, always with his eyes open, finds Mikey Dixon.
Team Kate Longworth.
101, 100 and, oh, sorry, I don't know if you heard me. I was just doing my exercises. Kind of a big deal down here. Just joined here by Ron Burgundy and many, many cutouts out here. A lot of famous Phoenix stars down here from the sports scene to folks we've seen out here at GCU games. There are 250 fans in the stands, all safely, socially distanced, masks are on. If you do see a couple players a couple fans in the stands next to each other, they're probably roommates or family members already in each other's pod, if you will. Safety first on the mind so we can get back to playing the game that we love. Right, guys? Basketball, it is here. Thank goodness.
The King's here. Thank you very much.
That's pretty good Elvis you did there, Barry.
Thank you very much. James Doan in the game for GCU. In the paint, outscoring Grambling 6-2. That was at the shot clock going off, but he got it off in time, but unsuccessful in the shot.
I give some credit to the Tigers defensively coming out of that timeout. They really locked in defensively. Lopes had nothing, settled for a desperation three at the buzzer.
Sean Miller Moore on the court for GCU as well.
Yeah, Coach Bryce Drew said he's going to use at least eight guys tonight here in this first half. He hopes to try to get nine or ten, but the game will dictate that.
Dean Isidore also on the floor and was instrumental in that ball going out of bounds.
Look at those eyes on Coach, but I tell you what, those are eyes of a guy who has played in the NCAA tournament a few times. He's focused, locked in, making sure these guys know what they're supposed to be doing. And remember, you got some new pieces out there playing together for the first time, so be a lot of instruction going on.
Careful protocol with basketballs as well. Stone near side. Sean Miller Moore back to black shirt. Zidore off the waiver. Transfer from Weber State. Black shirt stops. Stone moves in. Stops. Pops. Too heavy for Stone.
Yeah, he didn't make that one. He got a little extra adrenaline pump right now. The first game of the year. But I like that little one dribble pull-up jump shot in the mid-range game. You don't see a lot of guys execute that very well, but his form looked excellent on that attempt.
Edwards turning, doesn't go, pulled down by another big man in Demon Zador.
How about that length? He got some pogo sticks for legs. Remind me of that kid Bryce Oppo.
And a good bucket there from Javon Blackshear Jr.
Man, JBJ, his shot does look much better. Coach Drew's right. His kid's really putting in the time, and it's showing here early.
Slowly moving up, Peyton Taylor.
I think they only gave him credit for two on that one, Barry. He must have said he had a toe on the line.
Cobb drives it off the glass, pulled down by Mithgar. Already we're seeing rebounding. Pass swatted away by the Tigers, bringing it up. Edwards on the drive. Stopped.
Yeah, I got a foul there on that drive. A little body contact. If you're a coach, you don't mind that at all. You get him early, make him take a side out of bounds. No harm done.
Sean Miller Moore called for the foul. The transfer from Oregon State. Native of Toronto, Ontario, Gabe McLaughlin comes in for Asbjorn Midgard. Gabe, sitting out last year, redshirt season, coming back from an injury as well.
Yeah, I'm interested to see how this kid does. He's a good kid, always had a smile, always, when he wasn't able to play, cheering for his teammates. He's got nursing a little bit of a knee thing right now, but out there snatching boards.
Right there he did. He was on this court probably the last time with in a game action. Friday probably was leading Basher to that state title.
Yeah, like some 1,400 days ago. There's something crazy I read like that. So, you know, he's excited to be back on the floor, back here in his hometown. He's going to have some nervous energy, but I hope this kid has a fantastic season because he's a fine young man.
Zidore at the line.
This kid looks good. I like his body makeup. He got a nice little stroke out there on the floor. He's got live legs. I think GCU's added some players. You look at some of their numbers coming in and on the stat sheet, and you kind of go, I don't know. You know, a couple points, a couple boards. But when you see him out here performing, you know, that it's already showing some good signs.
Great work with Jordan Jackson, their strength coach. Zidore was initially recruited by Bryce Drew and Casey Shawn's staff at Vanderbilt. They didn't have any scholarships left, so elected to go to Weber State. They're reunited here at GCU.
Oh, wow, three white shirts just down there crashing that glass.
Hey, McLaughlin inside, got a little hand on it. The Tigers lose ball, picked up by Cameron Christian.
Yeah, a little sloppy right now offensively. Like I said, that heavy adrenaline pump, first time out there, putting on that white uniform. And you know, guys, we'll settle down here shortly.
Really no opportunities, Coach Drew said. No scrimmages, no exhibition games.
Nobody in a yellow jersey inside. You wonder if this early season action here, and played almost 9 minutes now, that These guys aren't getting a little winded. They're getting a little sloppy with the basketball out there. Yeah, they're missing shots. They're getting a little sloppy. Missing free throws. Another turnover.
Quickly, McLaughlin up to Sean Miller Moore. Lost the handle on it a bit. Looking to turn, pivot. Oh, look at that.
I'll tell you what, it wasn't textbook, but he took his time and he got back under control and muscled up a shot underneath.
15-4 GCU over Grambling State on a 9-0 run on the Lopes. Christian. Randall. Taylor. Back out. Cobb. Top of the circle. Driving, trying to move. Game is a door call. Timeout on the floor. 11 on the clock in the opening half. We'll be back from GCU Arena after we step aside.
The radio on Pandora.
15-4 GCU over Grambling State here with 11 left to go in the opening half. Let's take a look at the men's basketball preseason coaches poll. New Mexico State on top.
Kind of a recurring theme, isn't it? New Mexico State.
Believe it or not,
if you're just tuning in, they're the team to beat in the Western Athletic Conference.
They are good. They're solid. They're long. They're well coached. Lopes obviously will have their work cut out for them to try to run them down in the tournament this year. But if they continue to play and listen, play hard, listen to Coach Drew, I think they're going to have a nice chance.
Look at the new names on there. Tarleton State out of Texas.
Yep.
And Dixie State out of Southern Utah.
Yeah, I think those two teams will come into the tournament and catch some teams by surprise. They are athletic basketball clubs, not real tall or long, but they get after it with their speed.
Billy Gillespie, named from the past, the head coach of Tarleton, Trailblazers from Dixie State. Look forward to see them here at GCU Arena. Ever-improving Western Athletic Conference. Oops, on a little bit of a drought. Actually, Grambling State, they don't have a point in the last 17.
Oh, they got one there. Blown assignment defensively. You always got to protect the inside. I know you want to switch out, maybe trap that ball, but fake that handoff. Two guys went to the outside. They left the basket unprotected.
Sean Miller Moore moves left.
Right into the 9-0 run.
Tigers putting some heat on. There's another turnover. Grambling State picking it up a little bit, right?
Yeah, well, defensively, they've been solid. I mean, and Lopes haven't really helped themselves. I think in just that extra little adrenaline pump, they've had some nerves to start this game, especially with some of the subs. But there's a nice three-pointer. You get a dunk inside, and you get the skip pass for a three-pointer on the weak side, and all of a sudden, a 15-4 advantage is now 15-9. They're right back in this basketball game.
Prince Moss hits it. Oh, lost the handle. Oscar Freyer, another pickoff. Randolph.
Who got that? Somebody went up there. Somebody went up and got that. Let's take a look at this one again, see if this is goaltending or not. But oh no, I guess it was deflected first, and then so the second one doesn't count as a goaltending call. It went up there and followed as Oscar Freyer gets just enough of it. Miller Moore says, "You shall not pass." Slaps it over there by the training staff.
Short for the rebound, put back by Prince Moss.
Okay, they're not, and all of a sudden now they get some easy buckets inside. He knocked the three-pointer down. Lopes getting a little sloppy here in the middle section of this first half.
Grambling State, known for their top-notch athletes. Whoa, and a big one there from John Vaughn, Blackshear Jr.
Oh, Blackshear Jr. A year ago, he wouldn't even have thought about taking that shot early in the season. Now he's knocking it down with confidence. He's got 7 points going this game with a couple of assists. Now, what happened to that good GC rebounding? Now, 3 offensive boards here for the Tigers, keeping them clawing back into this thing. 4-point disadvantage.
Dixon, Laver, Freyer, far side, driving towards the baseline. Inside to Labor. Tigers are tight. Little room there for Freyer, but he put it home. Yeah!
How about that two-man basketball? I mean, that's just good basketball. You throw it inside to me. When your guy collapses on me, I'm going to kick it back out to you and let you tee one up from the outside. It's plays like that just goes down an assist and a three-point shot, but it was really huge for the chemistry and the makeup of the ball club. Tigers back again with another jumper on the baseline.
Cameron Woodall puts that one home. 5-point Lopes lead. They led 15-4 at 1 point. Laver. Woodall playing Frayer tight. Finds a little seam here near side. Blackshear looking to draw. Foul call.
Go back to this one just a moment ago. I love this here. Frayer ropes it inside to his big fella. He sees he's getting double teamed and he kicks it back out there to Frayer, who drills that 3-point shot. That is good team basketball.
Great to see Oscar back on the hardwood for GCU.
Yeah, they really missed his presence last year. He's just like a Swiss Army knife, how much he can do defensively, blocking shots, getting steals, playing two or three different guys. Look at the big fellas down low, having a party. Look at that, 14 feet of fun down there around that basket. Well, Tigers can't do nothing with that. See what this guy looks like from the free throw line. I like his body already. 70 pounds, he's got some good mobility. And let's see what the form looks like.
51% free throw shooter.
Yep, but I like the form. Now a little strong there. That's an extra adrenaline. I don't know how to explain it. If you never put on a jersey at a post-high school level, but something about the first game gives you a little extra adrenaline that you don't experience in a scrimmage or a practice. Got to get that under control.
Looks 0 for 4 from the free throw line.
Yeah, Frayer got his hands on it. He was trying to tip that thing a couple times. Just let his big fella come back and get it.
Hold on. Traffic in front of him. Quickly to Dixon. Dixon into the paint. Kick back out. Blackshear down low. Laver looks for mid guard. Oh, look at that. The big man, Brian Thomas, for the Tigers.
What a little lackadaisical. I would have liked to see him go up with two hands in that painted area there and really try to power it through the bucket.
20-15, GCU on top of the Grambling State Tigers. Talked about some of the familiar faces for Lopes fans. One of them, Javon Blackshear Jr. He's stepping up, and he looks like a floor general once again in game one.
Yeah, JBJ, I like to call him, because the kid is just plays beyond his years out there. You really can't even call him a junior. He plays like a senior out there on the floor. Really has improved his outside shot, without a doubt. You can see that confidence in his strokes. Got 7 points in this game, and he's going to do a nice job distributing the basketball as well. I love that one right there on the little high post game. Cooper dribbles and pulls up for the jump shot. And then this one here, after he got his shot blocked, doesn't hang his head, goes back, gets a steal, gives it over to Mike Dixon. He finishes it, and I love that one there. Come over here, give me a little side screen, and I'm going to take one dribble to pull up. And this is just a little catch and shoot. But off to a nice start. His numbers right now. He got seven. We talked about the 6 points. That's right. They changed that 1-3 from to a 2. He's 3 for 6, 50%. A couple assists and a couple rebounds. We talked about him being a stat sheet stuffer last year. The only player in Division I basketball with more than 300 points, 150 rebounds, and 100 assists. I mean, that's amazing. That's only been done like 7 times in about the last gazillion years.
For every 3-point shot that GCU makes, Copper State Credit Union will make a donation to the Students Inspiring Student Scholarship. For more information, please go to giving.gcu.edu. Barry Butel, Scott Williams, came on over back to GCU Arena. It's been a little while, hasn't it?
A long time. I like our little setup up here. When I first walked up here, I felt like I was in the penalty box with all this plexiglass. But
I like it. I like
Jared's
it.
Way down there. Memories. I don't have to worry about him elbowing me anymore.
He's all elbows.
You know, this is pretty cool. I didn't think there was going to be any atmosphere or energy in the building, but they've done a great job with the pep band, the dancers, and the cheerleaders, really making this feel like a normal GCU game. They're loud. They're always loud.
They are loud. Loud and proud. Frayer. Back to Blackshear. Pass to Laver. Come out. Rambling tight. Wow, just throws it up at the buzzer.
That's tight. The Grambling Tigers, they come out of that timeout, man. They have put their shoelaces on a little tighter, and they really get after their opponent. That's a couple times now they have absolutely stifled GCU coming out of those breaks.
Woodall stops. Heavy on that.
Oh, yeah, they're pushing it back right there. Big fella.
Tough when nobody's around.
It's true, struggling, trying to get used to that face covering there. Keeps coming down up underneath his chin. Gotta get him one with one of those chin straps. So keep in one place. Guys are probably hard to shout instructions to your players, because I know sometimes when I just have to go in and order something, someone's talking to me. I'm like, what? You know, I got those 52-year-old ears, but half the time I can't even hear the words that they're saying. It sounds like the parents on the old Peanuts cartoons, you know, just mumbling.
Prince Moss inside the arc, short. Blackshear brings it up.
Nice job by the Tigers getting back initially, but they left open a trail shot. Hickard didn't want it.
He didn't want it. Labor off the glass and in, a hoop and a harm.
He wants it. He wants it badly. You know, his freshman year, he'd have caught that ball. He would have shot that thing like it was a live grenade right there from 12 feet. Now he was a senior year. He realizes that all I got to do is put it down one time hard and explode to the bucket. Finishes with the concentration after the contact. He's got 4 points. Looking for 5 from the free throw line. The three-point play the old-fashioned way. Couldn't wait to say it. 257 days since I've been saying the old-fashioned way. We didn't shoot all those threes like they do now, Bear. We had to work inside and get those buckets of hoop and a harm back in the day. Oh, got Mickard again, pushing off again. That's a silly foul for the young big man.
You had to play on one leg, too. Remember that? in the snow.
Exactly. Take the public transportation to the games, too. They didn't even give a team bus for it.
That's terrible.
Side back to Woodall.
Yeah, Christian in there, huh? Okay, he was back in there. Look at him battling down there. I'll tell you what, that was a nice little patient offensive play there. They got the ball down on that left block. Tigers aren't going easy into the night tonight. They said none of those 30-point blowouts this time, GCU.
Oh, Blackshear looked pretty. Didn't drop. Quickly up the court. Christian. Fouled by Frayer.
Yeah, they got Frayer down there. He had the angle on Frayer. That's a good foul. Thank you, Murray, from the free throw line. You got beat transition. That won't make Coach Drew happy. But last thing you want to see him is come down there and get an uncontested layup or even that light foul where the guy finishes the basket.
Alessandro Labor passes Chad Briscoe. Remember the Lopes, 91 through 93 for 6th. GCU career scoring with 1,314 points.
Climbing up that ladder. The leader's Josh Braun, if I remember correctly, with about 1,700 points. So he got his work to do to catch Braun. But nice job by Labor. He really has improved each and every year in a low shooting.
First career start back in 2017 was against Grambling. Not a bad run since that first start. Has started 90 of the 91 games since for Alessandro Labor.
Right back into that 1-2-2 press, full court press, trying to get the Lopes of confidence up. We also have a three-point game, Barry.
Yes, we do. 2 of 2 from the line are the Tigers. 0-for-5 from the free throw line are the Lopes. Approaching 6 minutes to go, opening half. Frayer. Putting down the lanes there. Labor down low.
I like that slice play that they ran there. They should have had Labor underneath, wide open with a guy pinned on his back. Frayer couldn't get him the ball. But I like the way they stay patient with their offense. If it's not there, don't force it. continue to go to your second and your third option, and it's time to drive it hard to the basket and they get, pick up that foul. Both teams with five team fouls, so with 5 minutes and 53 seconds to go, probably one of these teams is going to get themselves into the bonus situation.
Prayer inbound, Dima Zador leaves for Blackshear. Flavor. Prayer looks for three. Short. Rebound. Pulled down by Brian Thomas.
Well, that's good recognition. I know our shot didn't go, but the defender went way underneath that screen, left Prayer plenty of time to size up that shot. Later in the season, those would be dropping like flies.
Taylor. Woodall. Heavy. Rebound. Dixon lets it go out. Lopes will inbound. Waver out. Sean Miller Moore comes on the court.
A little smaller GCU basketball team now. Both the. Oh no, Labor's still out there. He's still out there. He was taking the ball out by the bench. We couldn't see him hitting in that corner.
Oh, nice bucket from Blackshear.
Yeah,
he is. Nice one.
Yeah, and a well-designed play right there. That's a beautiful designed play. As Dixon's able to come off the screen. Nobody picks him up, and he had plenty of time to be able to eye that ball right to the top. And at that point, it's just a long free throw.
Tight D by Blackshear. Trying to turn on it. Unsuccessful Peyton Taylor.
Back to this one more time here. You just get this high pick here. What is Dior sets that high, Dima sets this pick right here. Nobody there to help. And Blackshear just knocks it down.
Three of eight are the Lopes from the arc.
Sean Miller Moore is another player to keep your eye on this year for the newcomer here for the Lopes. Be able to put the ball on the floor. He should be able to help break this trap. He'll be able to attack the basket, play up above the rim.
Three seasons at Oregon State. Stop, pop, Blackshear.
Okay. Javon Blackshear making a statement in this first half of this game. He says, you guys might be sleeping on my shot from a year ago. I'm going to make you pay for that. 11 points, 3 boards, 2 assists, 2 steals. Hold on. All in the first half.
Guarding Taylor tight as well. There, backs off. Up over the top. Back. Edwards drives. Frere. Oh, Frere.
Yeah, a little faster than anybody Frere's been going up against in practice. He just put the jets on him and went hard to the basket. What'd they call? Goaltending? What was the call on that?
Goaltending.
Okay, goaltending on that one. I thought maybe they called it for a foul.
Von Miller Moore. Wondering where the whistle there wasn't.
Yeah, Sean Miller Moore's wondering where the whistle was too. He's like, the dude knocked me down like he was a Mack truck, and I can't get a whistle.
6-point GCU lead with 3:59 to go here at GCU Arena. We'll be right back.
I'm rib and a fried egg. How about now? The new prime rib and fried egg biscuit at Hardee's. Feed your happiness.
Came up last.
We welcome you back inside GCU Arena. Lopes right now with a 6-point lead over Grambling State. Just under 4 to go in the first half as Coach Drew makes his coaching debut with the Lopes. And then on Friday, Coach Molly Miller will take the court for the first time with the Lopes as well. Looking forward to her debut. We will be carrying some of the women's games throughout the 2020-2021 season here on Fox 10 Extra. You see a question mark for Saturday. All the protocols are in place for the Lopes men's basketball team to take the court. However, safety first, so we will see what match question mark, because the only thing we can count on during these 19 is change and everything changing by the minute, right, guys? Meanwhile, on Tuesday, the men's basketball team also in action against Mississippi Valley State. We'll be there for all these home games as the Lopes have 8 non-conference home games scheduled here throughout November and December. Coach Drew, he's excited, guys, to be out there with his team. We've mentioned several times they're not going up against guys in the purple uniform. They get to go see how their game plan plays out against their opponent, finally.
They got to enjoy that.
Hey, and I got a free throw, too. Sometimes that's nerves. Sometimes it's adrenaline. It's going to happen. They're going to be a good free throw shooting team. It's all said and done. Nice looking stroke. I commented on his stroke earlier. He went up there and he bricked two. Comes back and makes the next two. Got to like that.
Shot clock didn't start.
Everybody's a little rusty from such a long layoff.
We'll reset and bound at midcourt. Taylor, near side. High by Blackshear. Back out. Edwards. Has it Taylor, near side. Moving the ball around. Woodall for three. Off the mark. Big rebound up high. The door pushed it out. Pulled down there by Kelton Edwards. Near side. Taylor. High by Jaden Stone. That's some help. That doesn't go. Rebound pulled down again by the Tigers. Edwards puts it home.
Second opportunity is a kill. You drive a coach mad over there on that sideline.
Sean Miller Moore wanted it badly, but Brian Thomas said no.
Yeah, Brian Thomas gets all ball, but Miller Moore, he does the right thing. You got to attack shot blockers. You can't shy away from shot blockers. All you young players out there, I'm mad if somebody swats your shot. You go in there and you get that body contact like Miller Moore does right here. Look at all that body contact underneath. You go to the line and shoot your two free throws. You try to shy away and pump fake and fade away. You're just giving those shot blockers opportunities to measure and close that distance and knock your ball into the third row.
Waver out.
Miller Moreland plucked up plays before. He went in there, got knocked down, and he didn't get the whistle. He didn't shy away from contact the second time. That's the kind of things you like to see. 200-pounder. Not afraid to throw his body around.
Gabe McLaughlin back in the game, and Liam Lloyd steps on the court. The freshman taking a breath. It's Father Tommy, associate head coach at Gonzaga University. Closing 3 minutes to go, opening half. So glad you could join us tonight for this debut for GCU and head coach Bryce Drew. Foul by Zidor.
Yeah, a little confusion on that weak side. I think they thought they were supposed to switch and could not recover in time. Had to commit that foul or risk giving up the easy basket. One of the things we talked about is no blown assignments defensively. It's hard to do in the first half of your first game. But communication's important. You got to talk out there defensively and use your hand signals. Let guys know where they're supposed to be on the floor. That will improve in the first half of this season. Yeah, it'd be nice if the Lopes were up 15 right now, but this kind of game might even be better for them. An 8-point basketball might even be better for them going into the locker room at halftime. And Coach Miller knows he's going to have the attention of his players rather than have them being up, you know, double figures, 15 points.
Aaron on the second free throw. Miller Moore, Blackshear quickly. Liam Lloyd. Blackshear. Zidor comes out, looks for three. That was heavy. Rebound. Pushed out. Knocked out by the Tigers.
Right, Gabe was down there on that offensive glass. He tried to go for the tip jam, and one of the Tigers was like, oh, no, you don't. He knocked it out all over there by their Tigers bench. But nice job that time executing the offense against that zone. I'm sure they probably haven't faced a zone as that extends and is as quick as this Tiger zone defense is. So talking to Coach Drew before the game, he knew they were going to play a lot of different looks, and especially a zone look, and sometimes it's hard to prepare in practice to face a team that does it so well, even with your backup player. So they're getting a little bit of everything here in this first half from this Tigers group.
10 GCU players have been on the court.
They wanted to get to 10. He told me he'd like to try to get 10 guys out there in his first half. He did it.
They're 2.5 to go. Inside, Cade McLaughlin.
How about that? Nice little pick and roll. Javon Blackshirt hung with it a little bit longer. Took Gabe to get his head turned around and pick that ball up. And he doesn't put the ball on the floor when he got in that painted area. He went strong up with it. Blocked down there on that baseline. It's going to send the Tigers to the line for the 1-1.
Liam Lloyd called. 8 of the 10 have scored for GCU.
That puts the Cameron Christian.
Into the Tigers, number 22, Prince Moss. Lead is 10 at the line. Cameron Christian. Allen, Texas, the redshirt junior guard by way of Boise State.
I like those shoes he's got on, too. He's got some red shoes on. Red and black, some white stripes. Adidas. Say, Coach Drew, I don't think, has sat down the whole game. And then he just went down, sat down for like 2 seconds, popped back up again. He's got ants in his pants.
Liam Lloyd, sworn. Kick back out.
Yeah, and then we keep it.
Christian called for the foul.
Lopes had made 4 free throws in a row until that miss, but I'd like to see him take his time a little bit more at that ball. He gets into that shooting rhythm really quick after he receives the basketball. Let's see if he takes a little bit more time with the second one.
He last played with Southwest Missouri State on March 2nd, 2019 versus Belmont. Dave.
Some of the kids have some family here tonight, right? Weren't some family members allowed to come down and watch this game here?
Part of the 250?
Yeah, 250 students and family members.
Pulled down by McLaughlin.
And that's an arena that seats 7,800. So definitely social distance happening out there.
Yeah, no doubt. Lloyd for 3. Heavy. Pulled down by the Tigers. Travell Cunningham brings it up. Far side. Eyed by Lloyd. Crosses over. Near side. Looks for 3. Tiger arching. Shot off the mark. Hits Moss off the mark. Driving. Heavy traffic. Ball's bouncing around. Travel.
Yeah. You know, they didn't get the first initial rebound, but Lloyd does a good job sliding his feet, forcing his guy away from the middle down towards that baseline where the big guy was able to come over and disrupt the whole action down there, caused the turnover. So nice job after not getting that ball. They stayed with it and still get the defensive stop on the turnover.
Tigers with 7, the Lopes with 6 turnovers. Kind of expect that in the opening game, right?
Absolutely. I'd be surprised if they didn't have, each team didn't have 15 to 18 turnovers in this game.
Rebound on the miss, picked up by the Tigers. Cunningham. Look to feed down low, doesn't go.
Oh, that's when he wants back. He had it right there. He got that basketball, came down, went back up strong with it, and just couldn't get it to drop. Lopes going to try to play for the last shot of the half.
Grambling coaching staff on their feet. Donnie Jackson. 14. 10 on the shot clock. 8, 7, 6, 5. Blackshear throws up the 3. Not there. Rebound. Nobody there. Long attempt by the Tigers off the mark. 34-23, the halftime score. GCU on top. They were up 15-4 at one point. As the Tigers storm back to narrow the margin, they've opened it back up to 11 for GCU.
Yeah, it's some good and some bad in that first half. I think Coach Drew will be happy with his performance.
Let's send it down to Kate Longworth with the head coach.
All right, thank you, guys. Coach Drew, first and foremost, how did it feel to just be on the court in real live game action?
Yeah, it's great to be out there. You know, this team, all the teams in college basketball have waited a long time to be out here. So it's almost surreal looking out here, seeing all the cutouts and actually that we have a game. To see how the last 8 months have gone, but happy with our guys. Thought we came out with some energy to start the game.
lots of energy, and Blackshear going out there leading all scorers right now with 11 points to his name. What have you seen from his first half action?
He was really aggressive. I thought our guys set some good screens for him, got him in some good positions, and credit him for making shots.
All right. Thank you so much, Coach Drew. We'll see more action in the second half. We appreciate your time. Coach Drew going to join his team right now. Meanwhile, we will be back here with you in just a few moments with more Lope Halftime Show coming your way. Right now, GCU on top, 34-23 over Grambling State. We finally have men's college basketball happening, and we're going to have a lot to talk about in just a few moments. Don't go anywhere.
The way they season it, the way that it's made, Kessel Burger.
Welcome to the Xfinity Black Friday sales event. Welcome to 15 days of saving on fast, reliable internet and mobile with nationwide 5G on the most reliable network. Plus, learn how to save up to $500 with Xfinity Internet and mobile. This sale won't last. Click, call, or visit a store today.
Keep your eyes on the Monster Angus Thick Burger. With sizzling bacon and 2 1/3-pound Angus beef patties, the Monster is your daddy now. The Monster Angus Thick Burger at Hardee's. Feed your happy.
Longworth, welcome you back here to GCU Arena, where the Lopes have an 11-point lead over Grambling State here at the half. And I'm welcoming you to the Lopes Halftime Show, coming at you in partnership with Sneaky Big right here on Fox 10 Extra. Well, we have mentioned things look a little different here inside GCU Arena, but no doubt the love for the game still on display for this men's basketball team as Coach Bryce Drew makes his coaching debut. And in just a couple short days on Friday, the women's basketball team, fingers crossed, will also take the court during these crazy COVID-19 times with a new head coach at the realm as well. We take a look at what Molly Miller brings to this folks program.
Ready? Compete! You've got to have a motor to play in the system.
Here you go.
You want to play fast? This is how we're going to play fast. Camp Grit might not be my favorite camp day. Okay? It's probably camp lockdown. Quick, action, jump. We are going to cut down nets because we're going to be great defenders. Stunt with your left, trace with your right. Show me a bucket right here. Atta, baby.
Now, sometimes you have to mic a coach or a manager up for hours or days to get video like that. But with Coach Miller, not so. She brings that fiery passion courtside, and it rubs off on her team. She said to me earlier today that she just wants to show off the energy. She believes it can be contagious, and she hopes that will be on display Friday night in the Lopes debut game for this 2020-21 season against Weber State. And as the season plays on, we'll be bringing you some women's action right here on Fox 10 Extra. And as I mentioned, I did have a chance to talk with Coach Miller earlier tonight, and she just said that she's very excited to be making the jump from Division II to Division I basketball, and her records perhaps speak for themselves. The past 2 years as the reigning Division II Coach of the Year back-to-back season, she had a 67-1 record. Absolutely impressive, and I think what's best, as President Mueller explained to me today, she just brings that charisma that he wants to see, and also preaches the character he wants to see in players and coaches here, where they do things not only on the court.
Off mode to get game ready with uninterrupted radio on Pandora.
Back at GCU Arena, where it's 34-23, GCU over Grambling State. Barry Butel alongside Scott Williams.
Well, opening half, we saw a little bit of things that we like. The rebounding, wow, that was on show early. Got a little messy first game. Got to expect them to be a little bit sloppy.
Yeah, a little sloppy in that first half, but really did some good things. You can see this GCU team has got a lot of size and muscle, and that's going to be mean good things for them as the course of the season goes on. Javon Blackshear did a nice job running the ball club out there. Got some guys come off the bench that were a little bit nervous. Got a little sloppy there in that mid part of that first half, but then they kind of ride the ship and got back under control, made some shots, and Coach Drew nailed it. You know, they're setting some big time screens out there, freeing up their shooters.
Let's take a look at our first half highlights, brought to you by Arizona Leadership Foundation.
Well, I like this one right here. He saw the guy was wounded and went over there and attacked him and stole the ball after he'd gotten in swat again. I'll hit him. Mikey Dixon lays it in. And this is a good one right here. Just off of that high pick, knocked down the tray ball from the top of the key. He was 1 3-point field goal in that shot. Had himself 11 points on 5 of 10 shoes. And then the big fella down low, Alessandro Laver, does a nice job. Oh, there's one more from Blackshear. I'm sorry. Knocking down that jump shot as well. And then go look at Laver. He does a nice job getting that ball down there on that paint and scoring area and using his size and his length and his experience and getting on the offensive glass and putting this one in. I love this one right here, but he would have shot that shot there from a little corner jump shot 3 years ago, and now he has the experience to power that ball to the basket. See, that's 41% shooting, but look at the defense, Barry. That's what I'm talking about, holding the Grambling State Tigers to just 32% and only one made three-point shot.
First half stats brought to you by Commonwealth Insurance. The way insurance should be is you take a look at the points in the paint. Fast break points in favor of GCU as well. This was a game that got cut to three at 22-19 before the Lopes opened it up late there by 11 points. 8 of the 10 on the floor for GCU have put points on the board.
Yeah, they got themselves back under control. That extra adrenaline pump, sometimes it's good, sometimes it's bad. I think that they managed that after the initial juice of, and then they settled themselves down and did a nice job. That's 6 turnovers in that first half, so not a bad number as far as the turnovers go either.
All right, Kate Longworth will be back with more of our halftime festivities here from GCU Arena in the debut performance for head coach Bryce Drew. We'll be right back after we take this timeout.
Isn't it the way that it's made? Kessel Burger. Mm-mm.
Lopes basketball underway here in Coach Bryce Drew's debut with GCU. Right now, the Lopes with an 11-point lead over Grambling State. And leading the way for the scores for Grambling State, Edwards with 6 points, Moss with 5 points. They also have 3 players with 4 points to their name. Meanwhile, on the Lopes side, Mikey Dixon with 5, a couple players with 4, Laver and Miller Moore. And leading the way for all scorers is Javon Blackshear Jr. Coach Drew telling me he's just really stepped up his aggression so far in this game. He likes what he sees from the young player, and we were expecting big things from him last year. He carried through. It's exciting to see what he'll be able to do this year, and we'll be with you all year long here on Fox 10 Extra, bringing you Lopes basketball. We're just about to get the second half underway as we head to break here, and safety first on the mind. We know that the 6th man is important here in GCU Arena, but right now 250 fans in the stands today, a lot of cutouts, and of course everyone's in a mask. All right, mask up and Lopes up. We'll be right back.
Uninterrupted radio on Pandora.
It was Kate Longworth back at GCU Arena, 34-23. The Lopes over the Tigers from Grambling State. Mentioned how Javon Blackshear Jr. leading with 11 points, but how about Mikey Dixon as well? He's got 5 points with help from Javon Blackshear Jr. as well.
Yeah, Mikey Dixon, I mean, this is a guy that came on in the second half of last year, started really getting played with some confidence. I love this one right here. Just uses his wheels, beats everybody down to the bucket, and then that was just after a good rebound by Oscar Frere. They push it ahead. Javon Blackshear's got his eyes up, finds Mikey Dixon in a spot down there on that right wing and knocks it down. So nice job. And they're going to be a nice little duo, that Dixon-Blackshear backcourt. Played 11 minutes. Javon Blackshear, he went 19 minutes in that first half. Nothing unusual for him. He played, averaged about 35, just under 35 a year ago. So we're looking to see what kind of adjustments are made here at halftime, how well his team can respond to that little full court trap. They turned it over a couple times in that first half. Want to make sure they take care of that basketball in the second half. And continue to attack that zone defense inside. I think they did a nice job punching that ball down low.
Labor back out on the floor. You're talking about Mike Dixon, the transfer from St. John's, 11.8 points per game a season ago.
Yeah, I tell you what, I actually, they said that Alessandro put on some muscle, but I think he's actually slimmed down a little bit. He looks a little bit more like Matt Jackson kind of a build than he did, you know, came in as a freshman because he was big, but he was puffy. Yeah, now he looks like he's got his BMI at a level that he really likes. Not like me.
Always nice to have Matt Jackson reference. Yeah. Come on, cut out in the stands. Whoa, old Frayer.
Yeah, how do we get a cutout? I got Jackson. Jackson. I saw Josh Braun. You know, me, you, and Kate, we gotta start making some noise and see if we can get ourselves a cutout by the end of the season.
Dude, there's Josh.
Who's that on the left? Was that?
There's Shellis and Josh. That looks like, is that Paul Panichello?
Oh, baseball player.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that Paul?
Well, we're going to work on that. I don't know who I need to talk to, but I'm going to start writing some emails.
Ah. Who knew there'd be so much drama around the cutouts?
Yeah, cutouts are big, like bobbleheads, man. I never had a bobblehead. I never had a cutout. I want something. All right, let's see what these Tigers got coming for these Lopes here in the second half offensively.
Cunningham looks to drive. Had to pull it back. Pivots away from the screen there. Randolph.
I'll tell you what, Tigers worked hard for that bucket right there. They got the ball from side to side a couple times, which always softens up the defense. And they get a little 8-foot push shot right in front of the bucket.
Frayer near side.
They're back in that zone defense. We'll match up zone defense.
All alone, Frayer.
A little flat.
Picked up by Cameron Christian. Back out, stepping back, Cunningham.
Yeah, a little mismatch there with the big fella attacks his feet.
Oh, did you see that nice feed?
Wow, that was nice. Yeah, they got a mismatch out there. The big guy out there, ISO, 25 feet from the basket. He wanted no part of that. He should have backed off rather than let the guy drive past him. There you go. Ahead, you knock down the outside shot. I'll just punch on your backside. When you give up that drive, then a lot of guys have to collapse the ball. A nice dish, found his teammate.
Tigers coming out on fire. Put an end to that mid-guard attempt to Thomas. Short on the long distance shot, kicked back in. Here come the Tigers. Near side, stopping there is Kristen. Back to Cunningham. Looks for some help from Thomas. Kicked back out, loss. Stops, pops, in and out. Midgard ends up with it.
Midgard's done a nice job on the boards. What did that give him now? Looks like he's got himself 5 rebounds in this game. Make it 6. Stat guy's a little slow. That'd be good. He can go out there and get himself 10 boards every night. That'd be lovely for GC. Nice little up and under, step through. And that one go in a couple games from now. That's a nice play down there. Forcing that ball. They're attacking inside. Got one mid guard, got it blocked. This time they go back inside to Labor, and he's a little bit more successful drawing that foul.
Randolph called. Labor at the line. 0 for 1 in the game.
Nerves calming down now. 7 for 14, got it up to 50% from the line. It's just a team, like I said earlier. I have no worries about them being a poor free throw shooter team. I think they're going to shoot well as a team on the course of the season. Guys that are going to log those heavy minutes will have nice strokes.
Alessandro, 79% a season ago. Cunningham. Leaves it there for Christian.
Oh, Midgard thought he had himself an easy block, and then Christian kind of moved the ball from the right to the left, right around the big fella, and got it in.
Frayer looks inside, Labor quickly, Dixon. Down low, Midgard. Oh, Thomas put an end to that.
Thomas comes over and tries to battle the big guy, but it's a little too late because he already had himself gathered and was going up with strength. You remember in the first half, Barry, he tried to go up with one hand and got swatted away. Quick learner, quick study. He goes back up the second time here in the second half, puts both of those big arms on that basketball and hands on that ball and tries to power through. And then anytime you go strong to the bucket like that, if there's some contact, officials are going to give you the benefit of the whistle.
McCunn connects on the front end. Now 1 of 3 from the line tonight. Helsingør, Denmark.
You ever been there?
Oh, I bet it's beautiful.
I've never been to that town or Denmark for that matter. But I'd like to go over there. There's a lot of those countries I had, Denmark, Sweden. I'd like to see those.
Yeah, a lot of Minnesotans where I'm from are there from Denmark.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, don't you know?
Look at that poke away by Javon Blackshear. Thomas? Oh, was Randolph got that one? Oh, my goodness. They are a long, athletic bunch, these Tigers. They will swat some shots. You come in there half-stepping, they'll send it up into those cutouts.
How about Grambling State, right? Super Bowl 22 MVP Doug Williams, NBA Hall of Famer Willis Reed, one of the top 50 greatest ever.
Put some players in some good positions.
Doug Williams. Randy Robinson, the legendary head coach. Buck Buchanan, the KC Chiefs. Great athletes from Grambling State.
Look at that extra effort. They didn't reward Oscar Freire, but the more you go, the more you get. Next time, that might not be a bucket. It might be a bucket.
Prince Moss by Midgard.
Yeah, he was right up over the 7-footer and laid that in. We got ourselves an 8-point game. Tigers are not going away.
Waver down to Midgard. Swarm 3 Tigers. Ha! Threaded the needle. It's getting brought up over there.
Well, that's what I'm talking about. This guy's not a stiff. I mean, he's on one side of the basket. He's able to get himself all the way to the other side. Uses the rim to protect his shot. I mean, probably didn't have to in that particular situation, but that was a pretty athletic move for a 270-pounder.
6 points, 6 boards for Midgard. Randolph, down low. Oh! Slammed it up against the glass.
Yeah, well, he's facing a lot of pressure down there by Midgard. Midgard grabs another rebound, but he's just down there. You know, that's what I'm talking about. Just a big roadblock down there, 7 feet. Look at this one more time here. I love that one because he fights himself through that double team and then comes back down here and gets a piece of that shot.
Hope's lead is 10. We'll be right back.
Rib and fried egg biscuit at Hardee's. Feed your happiness.
GCU basketball is brought to you in part by Sanderson Ford. The best play on a new Ford is at Sanderson Ford. By Herf Jones, by your side. By Community Tire Pros, serving Arizona since 1945. And by Talking Stick Resort, play in style. Back at GCU Arena in Phoenix, Arizona, where the Lopes are up by 10 over the Tigers from Grambling State. And this is the season opener for GCU basketball. So glad you could join us, Shrek.
Shrek down there by Chuck. You can't tell who's who if you paint
nice
Chuck green.
why
is he smacking Barkley all beside his head?
Time to take a look at our sweet play of the half, brought to you by Sweet James. How about his defensive play down low?
Yeah, I like that right there. We were just singing his praises here during the commercial break, and how this kid can actually really move at 270 pounds. He's mobile. He changes shots. He blocks shots. He rebounds the ball. He runs the floor. He sets a good pick. Rolls out of that pick nicely. I see why Coach Drew is so happy on him. I mean, he plays like a senior. I'm impressed.
Lopes improving that free throw percentage. They started 0 for 4. They now are 10 of 13 since that mark. Field goals here in the second half. Lopes just 1 of 5. Well, the Tigers came out 4 of 7 so far. Step back, a little heavy. Midgard with another rebound.
Just collecting those things.
Blackshear with a nice spinorama. Freire drive off the glass. Too much. Look at Midgard again.
What's that, 9 for this kid? I'll tell you what, he's chewing glass down there. That's a nice jump. Oscar Frere's got to go ahead and pull up for that jump shot when he catches that swing pass.
Jaden Stone downtown. Not there. Zadora tried to poke it away. Here come the Tigers. Nice spin move by Moss. Moss takes it. Oh, he wanted it.
Tell you what, Moss, he had a little angry intentions behind that drive to the basket. Got this steal. He keeps it, does a nice job shielding off Blackshear, not letting him get in front, and then just really attacks that basket, gets that contact.
Sidoro called for the foul. 78% free throw shooter a season ago for Prince Moss. Bessemer, Alabama. Sean Miller-Moore in for Frere. Whenever I say the word Alabama, you know I slip into that Keith Jackson Alabama. No? Alabama.
What a great call he has. Oh. There's this. Now, this is this what I wanted to see, what adjustments the Lopes made at halftime to handle this full court pressing defense right here.
There we go. Bust through it. Up to Blackshear.
Yeah, anytime you got Blackshear, that always helps.
Oh, I think, did he want to get that to Sean Miller-Moore?
Yeah, I think he was. I think Miller-Moore closed a little more distance than Blackshear thought he was going to be out there on the 12 to 15 foot range.
Blackshear, short, rebound. Sean Miller-Moore got on it.
Yeah, Blackshear's, you know, got cold here in the second half. He was 5 for 10 in that first half. Hasn't had a bucket yet. That was a nice little spinning move in there. Not able to get it to go with the offhand.
Gore took a chop to the left side of his face there. Kristen. Short.
I wonder if fatigue is maybe setting in on some of these shooters.
Yeah, you wonder,
free
right?
throws are not looking. We're looking a little, little flat. And last couple shots by Blackshear is flat. That shot there, and Tigers was, you know, front of the rim and down. You got all that emotion. Sometimes you burn some energy on that emotion in the first half, and don't have a whole lot here for the second half. They'll be rotating some players in and out of there. I think guys will be giving a little tired signal, telling the coach, hey, I need a breather.
McLaughlin in for the Lopes. Midgard takes a seat. 10 offensive boards for the Lopes. Only 6 second chance points, though. Jaden Stone, McLaughlin, Blackshear in the corner. Moore back to Blackshear. Looks for some help from McLaughlin. Feeds Dima Zadore. Underhand.
Beauty. That's one heck of a drive right there. That's big time stuff right there. You get that ball 20 feet off that left wing, and you're able to slice through a little crease right into the front of the rim.
Cunningham pulls back out. Moves near side. Blackshear. Ooh, he almost picked his pocket. Christian. Heaves it off. Rebound. All white jersey.
Yeah, Gabe really went up there and claimed that basketball. He had a nice little help defense, too. He heads good on Blackshear's man. Then he fights back to the basket, gets that ball coming off the rim. Look at this dunk.
Oh, quick ball movement. McLaughlin is just stymied.
Oh, my goodness. That was that Cobb down there. I thought for sure Gabe was going to get himself an easy flush. But you say those Tigers, they really close to the basketball and play above the rim. It's one more time here with Zadore that gets a nice pass there from Blackshear and drives it right to the hole. And look at this pass right here. It's a beautiful dish, just drops it down to the bucket, unselfishly tries to get his teammate an easy bucket inside.
And he's coming up, Kelton. 11-point lead for GCU. Blackshear.
What do you think of Zadore?
I like him.
Okay, good. I hope I'm seeing the same. I'm seeing the same thing you are.
Look, oh my! Gabe McLaughlin.
Nothing wrong with his knee on that play right there. My goodness, that was Oscar Frere-ish right there. He sent that down with authority. Coach needs a timeout after that. Lead has grown to 13. He said, "Whoa, wait a second."
5 points, 5 boards.
Take
Gabe.
A look at this one more time. Just times it perfectly. Had a guy up underneath his left
armpit. Just slams it down with the hard right hand. Almost took the rim home as a souvenir. Look at this thing. Just collapses that rim down and some authority. He loves it.
Seeing some things coming together here, even in the opener. Depth is there. The size is there. Let's take a quick look around the Western Athletic Conference. Jabari Rice picked as the preseason player of the year by the coaches. New Mexico State Aggies relocated here to Phoenix due to COVID-19. They're right down the road, and they got a game against Arizona Christian. I believe they're at Arizona Grand. I don't know if we wanted to push that information out.
Oh, sorry.
Dixie State, Tarleton State joining the WAC. Going to be great to see both of those schools represented here in the Western Athletic Conference.
That's pretty cool. I'm going to go ahead and check out some of their basketball games. I really like the style in which they play. They play hard and talk about how long they are and very well coached and execute real well. And me trying to get into coaching, I want to start seeing not only, you know, what this coaching staff here, what Bryce Drew is going to do, but also going to check out what the New Mexico State does, because I think they do a real good job coaching up their guys.
They do, yeah. I mean, the record indicates it, and the success of the program is undeniable. Definitely a rising tide is one in which you hope that it raises all the ships, right? The competitive advantage, you hope that every team in the Western Athletic Conference strives for excellence.
Yeah, without a doubt. I think the newcomers coming in, you talked about Gillespie coming to the conference as well. He sure have his teams ready to perform when they step between the lines.
Eight Lopes with 4+ points in the game for GCU.
Those shoes I like. I got to get a pair of those. Those are sweet. I'll tell Jordan.
Bryce Drew, Scott Williams, and Michael Jordan, all former Chicago Bulls.
That's right.
Good drive there. Doesn't go for the Tigers. Jaden Stone brings it up for TCU. Hoffman. Quick one there by Woodall, almost picked it off. Stone. Sean Miller Moore. Dima Zador. Blackshear. 13 on the shot clock. Drives. Got a little bit of open rope. Oh! Not there underneath, though, and fouled. Dima Zador.
I like that, though. See, Zador comes over like he's going to set a screen. And then he slips to the basket. Blackshear, later in the year, will hit him on that play. This time he tried to use his wheels and just take it hard to the basket. Lopes a +10 on that glass, and that's what you want to see, because a year ago they used to get beat up on the glass in too many basketball games, so it's going to put a smile on that coaching staff's face to see, you know, with 11:55 to play, his team's got a 10-point rebound advantage.
In the far corner, trying to inch his way in there is Edwards. Turnaround, not going to happen.
One and done. They did not get any of those offensive rebounds they had in the middle section of that first half. I think they cracked that whip at halftime and said, no more second chance opportunities for the guys in the yellow shirts.
Thomas did pull down that rebound. Taylor in for the Tigers.
Yeah, that was a nice move there. Taylor does a nice job getting his first bucket. He got himself down below that free throw line. When the ball gets below the free throw line and you're playing defense, you're in a disadvantage in a big way.
Stone, Blackshear, Dima Zador, hands it back to Blackshear. Drives, got a little bit of room off the glass.
Right, got for travel. Yeah, just could not stop and slid his pivot foot.
Timeout on the floor with 11:06 to go. How about Gabe McLaughlin?
Send it home, big man.
Way that it's made? Kessel Burger.
Welcome back to GCU Arena. Debut of the new head coach of GCU basketball, Bryce Drew. The 14th in school history. The 13th in school history. We'd be remiss not to talk about Dan Marley. 7 seasons at the helm, leading this team into the D1 era, and they came out flying, gangbusters.
They really did. I mean, They made a name for themselves in the D1 basketball. The Havocs, this arena here, the competition that they played at Duke, played Louisville, Kentucky, Indiana, won 27 games, took his team to two WAC conference championship games against New Mexico State, put some players in the pros. You've got to like everything in the foundation and what he established here for Grand Canyon basketball going forward. Now passes the baton on to a son of a coach in Bryce Drew, who's going to do even bigger things with it.
Yeah, a solid foundation has been established for Coach Drew and his coaching staff, one in which is much heralded with the likes of Jamal Walker, who was here a season ago as an assistant to Brad Underwood at Illinois. Ed Schilling, who has associations with Coach Calipari, who was also on his staff there at Indiana, not with him at Indiana, but on his staff with the New Jersey Nets in the NBA as well. And Casey Shaw, a big man, former professional player in Europe, as well as a fellow first-round selection of the NBA, along with Bryce Drew.
Yeah, no, they got a solid squad, no doubt about it. President Mueller was singing their praises, and he got a call, he said, from Cal, Coach Cal.
Yeah.
At, you know, that you got yourself a top five program, a power five program, rather, and a coaching staff. And that's always important. You want to coach these guys up. These guys want to go play at the next level. There's a nice drive in there, going Woodall. Hard to the hole. And Woodall using that left hand off the glass. Now, again, one. GCU can't seem to keep that double-figure lead.
Right. Freyer back to Laver. Mikey Dixon on the near side. High by Taylor inside. Midgard threads the needle. Freyer quickly. Jaden Stone puts it down. Top of the key. Good!
That's great execution. Inside-out basketball. Boy, that makes my heart sing to watch that. I love when guys play that inside-outside basketball play together. Nothing wrong with getting a 16-foot jump shot right in front of the basket with your board covered.
Ninth look to score for Jaden Stone. 10 minutes to go. Turnaround, not going to happen. Midgard pulls down another rebound.
Goodness, this guy does like to chew the glass. Midgard doing a good job. They don't have him up here, so I don't know how many boards he's got, but he's got to be approaching double figures and rebounds.
Back out Stone, too much room for three, not going to happen. Freyer tried to fly in. Pulled down by the Tigers. Robert Johnson on the floor. There for Taylor. Taylor moves the ball around now to Woodall. Woodall. Kick back over to Brian Thomas. Finds Taylor. He'll back up. Move to his right. Hide by Dixon. Freyer over there in the corner guarding. Shot by the Tigers off the mark.
Yeah, another short one. Those long shots now as guys' legs are starting to get tired are always hitting the front of the rim.
That's no
what
bucket.
That's what you do. You start getting tired. You don't settle for outside shots. You put the ball on the floor one time for a pull-up, and the next time you take it all the way to the bucket.
Fourth team foul.
For the Tigers, number 12, Cameron Christensen.
Laver and Midgard on the floor.
Yeah, this is something the Lopes teams used to do really good. These baseline out of bounds plays, their execution was most excellent. Let's see if they can come up with a bucket here.
Laver, top of the arc, look down low. Near side, Blatcher, he'll drive. Stop, twist, turn. Ooh, try to kick it back to Midgard, but he was moving in. Didn't look all that clean by Randolph. Draws a foul. Laver smiling.
Yeah, he tried to get back there and do the old the soccer player move out there. He flopped trying to get that charge. Ends up tripping the Tigers and gonna go to the line for a couple free throws. But you know that offensive execution that last time down was a little bit lacking. And led to this easy run out here and a foul on the big fella.
Mark. Darian Randolph from Dallas, Texas. Led the team in rebounding last season.
Bouncing all around, didn't go. What do we got?
Lane violation.
Yeah, somebody got in there a little too early. Got caught creeping too soon. The extra shot here. It's like, you get three shots, you got to make one, right?
I saw what you're doing there. I see what you're doing there.
For old commentator jinx?
Yeah.
No, I wouldn't do that. It's too early in the season to be that mean.
Oh, wow.
It worked anyway.
Jaden Stone's back over quickly to the scorer's table. He's good for ready to check back in. Mikey Dixon!
Oh, what a great pass. I'm not sure if that was Frere or Devon Blackshear Jr. with that cross-court skip pass, but on time and on target finds Mikey Dixon for his second three of the game.
8 points for Mikey. Taylor. Move around Blackshear. Kristen. It's Frayer.
Oh, I do not know about that. It looks to me like Frayer does a great job presenting his chest. Look at that one more time by Frayer. He just whips a pass across court. Mikey Dixon sent it home. I like that. When guys point to the passer. Says, hey, thank you, buddy. Appreciate that dime. He gave me a great dime, and I was able to knock it down.
Jake Stone in for Dixon.
Excuse me. Frayer has not done the scoring tonight, but he's done a lot of the little things. It seems like whenever he's on the floor, the team goes off and gets an advantage. You know, his plus-minus would be off the charts tonight. Singing his prayers as he goes over and commits a second foul on the roll.
Second team foul.
Frayer can't believe this.
Goes by him. Let's see. Doesn't get him there.
I checked him on the left arm there a little bit.
Did he? Waves at him. And yeah, gets that left elbow. Didn't have anything to do with affecting the shot, but anytime you make player with a contact with a player and is in a shooting motion, you're going to get whistled for the foul. We've seen some good play. We've seen some sloppy play. You know, Cardinals sin. You don't foul an outside shooter shooting a three-point shot.
Yeah.
Little things like that will have to be cleaned up, but you expect some guys to make some mental mistakes and have a little rust on their games. Well, yeah, kind of with vision, you kind of things happen in front of you. Sometimes they that side challenge, there's a terminology for it that's escaping me right now. But
peripheral?
Yeah, having somebody come into that your peripheral vision, but as an actual term, guys take practice shots with one of the coaches challenging them from the side as opposed to always challenging, putting a hand up in their face. So you get used to that distraction of somebody coming at you from the side like that and have to keep your concentration and knock down your shot. That's not pretty.
Rest in peace.
I don't know what happened. I think our stat operator's gone home for the evening because they haven't updated the players on the floor, but I'm going to give Midgard 10 boards right now. And that's impressive. Make it 11. Jared's on top of it. They got 11 rebounds for this guy in his first game at a GCU arena.
Our stat broadcaster is frozen. Is anyone surprised of that here in 2020? Tigers almost had a bit of a highlight bucket there. It doesn't go, but they pulled down the rebound.
Just 34% shooting for the Tigers. You knew they'd be a little bit nervous coming in here, and they'll shoot better as the season goes on. They'll do, you know, good things in their conference, but they just have not been able to find the range tonight.
Midgard there, and Labor puts it back.
I'll tell you what, those big guys are kind of fun to watch. They're pounding that ball inside, chewing glass offensively and defensively. It's just going to be too long for a lot of teams that they're going to go up against. And too much weight. The weight that Laver dropped, Midgard picked up 270 pounds.
Driving off the glass. Nice one by Christian.
That was a sweet move. Cutting through the lane, not afraid of those big guys. And when you're struggling to shoot the ball from the outside, that's where you got to go inside and get buckets.
Laver for three.
Oh,
bam.
My goodness. Doing from the inside with the follow up and then the ability to go out there and get that ball on the secondary transition and knocking down the three-point shot. He's got 11 points now after a slow first half start. 6 boards to go along with those 11 points.
Prince Maw side by Jaden Stone. Stone getting some extended minutes here in the second. Poor Oscar. Oscar called with that. He shrugs his shoulders. His backup with GCU after being out last season for GCU. Wow, there's been so many new faces to talk about, and a number of them are scoring some buckets here. But we are introducing you to a pretty deep bench for Bryce Drew.
Yeah, he got 10 guys that can go to Forest Basketball Club. I'm impressed with all of them. They do a nice job playing hard, playing with passion. They don't always make the right plays tonight, but you can see that they're in the shooting form and way they can be able to move out there on the floor is impressive.
Yeah, we've talked about Ashbourne and mid-guard, Dima Zador. Also, Jaden Stone looking sharp as well in the game.
Yeah, I like this one here by mid-guard because 270 pounds. That was Miller Moore down there on that particular play going underneath. And then this is mid-guard down here just using his big frame and agility with that size to be able to get to the other side of the bucket and fight that one in. And I love, this is just a smart, real play here by Stone. He goes in there, and then McLaughlin says, let me help you out there and clean up that mess on aisle one. He slams that thing home, and this is the one I love by Stone right there because that's the one dribble pull-up from the jump shot. Then he got another one where he went hard to the basket as well. But, this is what you need. You combine some seniors in there with the young player there, and Jaden Stone gives yourself a nice little tandem coming up off your bench, and those guys could do some damage this year. So mid-guard, the big 7-footer. He's got 6 points and 11 boards, and Labor with 11 points and 7 rebounds. And then you get all these other guys coming in here and helping out in various ways. I really like the kid, Dima Zador, too. He's nice. And I've talked about the big Ashty. That kid, as a senior, plays a good, strong basketball game. And it was something when, you get with Labor, but you really have anybody like that since they probably had, Grandy Glaze and... those cats, the Smash Brothers, I think you got
Keontae
something.
Keontae Vernon.
Yeah, Keontae Vernon, one of the all-time rebounders for the GCU Lopes. I think you're going to have something like that, a little duo down there, the 33 and 25 running down the floor.
For every three-point shot that GCU makes, Copper State Credit Union will make a donation to the Students Inspiring Student Scholarship. For more information, please go to giving.gcu.edu. Back to 15, going to the line though, the Tigers. That one drops. Prince Moss. Seven points for Moss.
And they're back at that full court press. Some reps, run that baseline. And I didn't run the baseline. After that made free throw, you can run that baseline. Big fella stayed in one spot, and Tigers did a good job setting down all those passing lanes.
Good teaching moment here for Coach Drew and his staff.
You don't mind that timeout in a 15-point. You got a 15-point advantage. Better to take the timeout than force a poor pass that leads to a bucket or a turnover gives them the ball back. So you got plenty of timeouts with your 13-point advantage after those made free throws. Set up the play a little differently.
Tom. Mullets are
similarity. Twin mullets.
Got the hockey here.
Could be cousins.
Yeah. Oh, wow. I didn't say that.
Did you watch that documentary? I didn't. I refused to watch it.
I didn't watch it. Yeah. I think we were the two people.
Probably only two in the country, right? During the whole shutdown that didn't watch that. Yeah, I like Wild.
Kate also didn't watch it, apparently. So
good.
Just three of us.
All right. That's why we make such a good group.
Look at that. That's under Labor with their left hand.
Yeah, he just put that thing down and threw that right shoulder into the smaller defender and had his way with him. torture chamber.
I was reminded of the fact that we were too busy watching The Last Dance.
Yeah, Last Dance was good. I got some cameos in there.
I saw you in there.
Yeah. That's 240 and skinny.
Looking good.
Mid guard again. It seems like the ball, either he finds the ball or the ball finds him. He got himself a dozen boards.
I think Kate has some background on Coach Drew.
Well, yeah, you're talking about Scott's playing days. There's another guy who grew up watching Scott play. I mean, I'm not really good at math, you know. He must have been, 2 years old, and you must have been only 8 years old, right? Scott, probably your YMCA days, not North Carolina, I'm sure, right?
I think there's only a 4 or 5 year age difference there, Kate. I'll have you know.
But no, that's what I was trying to give you. I was saying I don't know how he admired you as a player because you guys are, the same age. I'm trying to help you here.
Yeah, I think
but
he was
point
nice.
Being, he was saying he always admired your style of play out there, and he was excited when he was coming over to the program because you'd be calling the games out here.
I told you,
my math isn't good. If I messed up on that compliment, I haven't seen you in forever. I was really trying.
I
got to
get my waiters on now, Kate. Yeah, so thick here. Wow.
Well, you know, he Coach Drew, when he got the job, he did reach out to me and said that he did enjoy watching me play. And I think because he was a son of a coach, was the only reason he probably enjoyed watching me play. I'm sure that Michael Jordan was the main attraction to get him to tune in, but being someone who's, pays attention to the little details on the floor, you know, I talk about some of these guys, you look at their stats, and you go, hey, I don't know if they ain't going to help this club, but when you actually see them play, you know that they're going to be able to contribute, and that's kind of how I always pride in my game. When I was on the floor, I just wanted the score to stay even or grow, the lead to grow, when I had my time on the floor. I didn't care if I scored or what my stat line was. I just wanted to be an important part of the team's success.
Be a part of it. I'm sure that this now very deep bench for GCU, each one of the players want to do exactly that. How about Alessandro Laver in the second half, Scott? 11 points and 3 boards.
Yeah, much, much better second half. He calmed himself down. He probably deferred a little bit to Javon in that first half because he had the hot hand going. Now he's kind of – Javon's cooled off a little bit, and he's picked up the scoring.
Ooh.
Oh, bad dribble handoff there leads to a turnover.
Yeah. Driving and putting it home, Kelton Edwards.
Ooh. Showing some ability to rise up to the 10th floor and throw that down.
You mentioned Midgard in his rebounding performance tonight. It's a new career high. 14 unofficially. Packing in now. Foul called. 3:45 to go. The Lopes have opened up the lead 59-44 over Grambling State. We'll be right back.
Time winding down here at GCU Arena right now. The Lopes on top of Grambling State 59-44 with under 4 to play. And on this eve of Thanksgiving, well, I'll tell you what, we are thankful to be watching college basketball. It's great to see everyone out here or tuning in right now on Fox 10 Extra. And tomorrow, the players, after this big game, will get a little break to enjoy the Thanksgiving activities. And we all know food is center stage tomorrow. So we talked to the players about what they want to see on the table tomorrow. Mikey Dixon saying sweet potatoes. A lot of votes for the mac and cheese and rice with stuffing coming in there. And guys, for me, I got to go stuffing and sweet potatoes as well. I also always vote whatever side dish I'm not in charge of. That's my favorite because no headache, no stress comes with it. What about you guys? What are you looking forward to tomorrow? I know first and foremost, we'll all be counting our blessings in this crazy year. But food-wise, what's on your mind?
Yeah, I'm a big sweet potato guy. I like them candy yams when they put the marshmallows on top of them and then brown the marshmallows on top of them. That's my favorite right there. I can go for 2 or 3 helpings of those in one sitting.
How do you feel about green bean casserole?
Love green bean casserole. I was almost going to go green bean casserole bowl. That's a close second.
1A, 1A,
if it's,
M1B?
If it's made right, if it's too mushy, then too, I don't dig it. I don't dig it.
No.
But if you can get it right, then it's – out of this world.
Yeah, there's a little controversy that's even going to be served tomorrow. And I'll tell you, I don't know if I'm showing up.
With a boycott Thanksgiving?
I hope I delivered the message.
I'm sure you will not be disappointed.
I don't think I will. Under 3.5 to go. Hope you're enjoying GCU basketball.
Okay, forget the size for a second. What part of the turkey do you like? Nice power move to the basket there. Are you a breast guy?
Of course I am. I'm a breast guy.
You like the turkey breast. Okay. Yeah. See, I kind of like getting that big turkey leg.
Really?
I kind of like getting that big turkey leg, and I'll put it in my right fist and just gnaw on that bad boy.
Wow, look at you.
Bam! Sean Miller Moore!
Dude, they're having some fun out there now, aren't they?
Yeah.
A couple big dunks in this game. Tigers want a timeout. And McLaughlin started out that rim wrecking. And Sean Miller Moore, I talked about him having some live legs. He went up and flushed that one big time.
Dante Jackson, the head coach, kind of shrugging his shoulders over. Hey, guys, 2:52 to go.
It's like his team checked out of his ball game for a second there. He had to either get their attention back and say, we play a whole 40 minutes in this program. Lopes 5 of 6 from the field here in their last 5 of 6. So, neither team has shot the ball all that well. I mean, Lopes only shooting 41% on the game, but, GSU is only shooting 32.7% on the game. So all those numbers are going to improve. There's some little jitters, guys with some tired legs. They're playing in this arena probably for, we've always seen some smaller programs come into the GCU arena and struggle from the field as well. Even without the Havocs, they're still having a tough time with all this crowd noise.
I have to admit, there's some characters that are cutouts. I don't know. Maybe I don't go to all the movies. I just don't know some of the cutouts.
We're getting old. I think some of them are these influencers, Instagram influencers. We have no chance at knowing who those people are.
I see Chance the Rapper's here.
Yeah, but no Chance the Rapper. It is something like a Kardashian. I'll pick that up. But outside of I do know Chance the Rapper. And that's the chick from Frozen.
The chick from Frozen. The chick from Frozen.
What's her name? I don't know her name. You know her name?
That chick. Yeah. Elsa. Hey, look who's in the house.
Zero to Hero.
That's
Kate's favorite guy.
Is it really?
I think so.
I saw a grimacing kind of Jared Martin as well here. He's very cantankerous. You know he's with California Baptist.
Yeah, I know. Now. He's gone over to the dark side
Betty.
On us, hasn't he?
Oh, isn't she pleasant?
Yeah. Oh, Jared Martin. We got to face him a couple times this year. He's on that staff over there at Cal Baptist. We were out of Aussie player for a while, and we got one this year, right? Didn't they added an
Jayden
Aussie?
Aussie.
There you go. Oh, bad pass. Trying to force one that time.
63-44, the opener for GCU. They're in control. That's a call.
I got McMillan on that one, but that was a good job that time. Edwards just says, I'm tired of missing these shots from the outside. I'm going to just attack the basket, get that body contact. Sometimes that's all you need is a couple free throws to get yourself going from the field. Now, it won't help them in this particular game, but that's the right attitude to have the rest of the season going forward. And if you're struggling to shoot the ball, you can't continue to pound away from the outside. You got to go inside and try to get a bucket inside or opportunity to get yourself to the free throw line.
Bryce Okpo checks in. Familiar to Lopes fans. Chance McMillan on the court, as you mentioned, and Rashad Smith. Pima Community College by way of Hamilton High School, the Chandler, Arizona native. McMillan up high! Oh, Smith didn't put it home. Too far away from the bucket.
I hardly recognized Okpo out there on the floor. He's got a different look. He's changed his hairstyle up here with the braided look. It took me a moment to spot him out there on the floor without the jersey name on the back.
Oh, that was lofty. Labor.
Labor has been a beast here in the second half. You see why he was such a WAC player of the year, preseason player of the year a year ago. He's not happy only being on that first team selection this year. He's come out here. Maybe it's a little less pressure. for them to come out and get to a good start here in the second half. But this is a well-rounded Lopes basketball club. I've liked what I've seen here in opening night.
14 points for Labor, four boards. As Edwards had a nice bucket there for the Tigers. Picked off by Grambling State. Driving, teardrop in for Terrion Randolph. Approaching a minute to go here in the opener.
1 minute remaining.
Blackshear, 36 minutes tonight. Breaks the one-man press. He gets his team up in the first half. And this is one of those timeouts that they just want to get a sub on the floor for Labor. Get Gabe a couple more ticks on that clock. And so you're going to go get another play. Probably Blackshear. We're just talking about the 36 minutes he's played tonight. Probably didn't expect to play 36 minutes, but things just run better when Javon Blackshear Jr. is out there on the floor. That's got to feel good. I mean, this guy's waited a long time to go against another opponent and come out here. Wasn't always pretty, but at the end of the day, the game was never in doubt for the Lopes. When Grambling cut it to three, they kept their poise, and no one splintered, started pointing fingers, and those are the types of things you like to see. Continued to work hard.
Was picked off, but
yeah, shot clock's about to blow up.
Yep, two. They got to throw it off. They're not going to. How about Ash?
You gonna give him a foul there?
Oh my! That
I don't like.
15 rebounds for a mid guard, a career high for him. That's the most for GCU since Oscar Freyer had 15 against UMKC back on March 8th of 2018.
The kid did some. He did his job on the glass. And yep. Give him an extra peanut butter and jelly sandwich on the way back to the dorms tonight. He earned it.
Wow.
At least that's what we used to get. I don't know. That was 30 years ago. We used to get PB&Js for our post game. I bet these PB&J. Kids probably get sub sandwiches now. I think that
you go
times
grape
have changed.
Or, you go grape or strawberry?
I'm grape.
Yeah. Oh, really?
Absolutely.
Old school.
And don't put any peanuts in my peanut butter. I like it creamy.
The chunky? You don't like
I don't
that?
Like the chunky? No,
yeah,
sir.
I'm with you.
And it's got to be Jif. I don't mess with anything but
Jif. I am totally with you on that.
That's why our chemistry is so good up here, my friend.
Who knew it was the peanut butter? My brother.
Yeah, this year I had to switch to wheat bread, though. I've always been a white
really?
Bread guy. Just
yeah, this year?
I had to switch to wheat.
Oh, good for you. Thinking healthy. How about free throw line? 10 of 11 from the free throw line this half for GCU after we talked about their opening half where they didn't start too strong.
Yeah, that's that extra adrenaline, maybe a little nerves, maybe a combination of both for different players experience it different ways, but they're going to be a good free throw shooting team this year.
Travell Cunningham, it's the front end. 19-point lead.
Yeah, so many different ways, and I'm thinking, you know, who we go.
Whoa, what are you doing? Hey.
Joker's getting a beat down over there.
Security.
Definitely need campus security to come take care of that. But a lot of different guys and a lot of good things out here. Okpo with the long shot there from the outside. Couldn't get that one to go. He was determined to get to that scoring column. There's a couple guys that did not get into that scoring column tonight. But they'll have plenty of opportunities this year. I think this Lopes team's going to play a lot of different guys. They got to stay healthy. You know, that's always the key for any teams to have success is stay away from that injury bug.
Dribble it out, and the Lopes are victorious. 69-53, the final score. And Bryce Drew, now 7-2 in debuts as a head coach, and he's successful in his debut as head coach of Grand Canyon University.
Yeah, it's got to feel good for Coach Drew and his staff. They've been waiting a long time for this night. And come out on the right side just makes it even sweeter. They can't even do the post-game handshake with the players anymore.
No.
They just kind of line up in a circle and maybe do the old-fashioned bow to one another.
This is unprecedented. Some fist bumps.
Yeah, they're doing a bow. Oh, maybe they're just bowing for prayer or something. That would taking a prayer down there, thinking if no one got hurt tonight. That's pretty cool.
That is all about the mission and vision of the university. Coach Schilling is leading it. post-game prayer.
Wow. Well, I'll tell you, 2020 is going to have a lot of different sights and sounds and looks, and that was a pretty cool one right there.
That was definitely, that would, I got to tell you, that kind of moved me a little bit. We've all been dealing with a lot here, and that put an exclamation point on it. Let's send it down to Kate Lawler.
All right, thank you, guys. Well, you would think with the height difference, we'd have that 6 feet social distance, but we're still playing it safe here as I'm joined by preseason All-WAC first team honoree, Alessandra Lamer. First of all, congratulations. After 259 days, you are back officially playing basketball. How did it feel just to be out on the court tonight?
I mean, it feels great. You know, after, like you said, 259 days, whatever it was, about, like, not playing basketball, it felt great to be out here with my family, my teammates, play and get a dub in the first game. There's a lot to work on, but, you know, after almost a year without basketball, like actual games, you know, it feels good.
And you guys score the victory for Coach Drew in his debut. What has he brought to this program?
You know, we came along together. We came with some really good recruits. You know, we're still trying to build like a chemistry that is coming. That is gonna come like in the next few games. You know, it's just great to be out here.
It's very cool because back in 2017, the first game you started for GCU was against Grambling, and now you're back out there. You have started 90 of 91 games. We have seen you grow so much throughout the program. Your senior year right now, these are kind of crazy times, but what do you hope the Lopes go out there and achieve this year?
I mean, our goal is always the same one. Win the WAC tournament, go to the NCAA tournament, trying to win a few games. And I think this year with the team that we got, if we keep improving like we are, I think it's achievable.
And then lastly, you've mentioned just the chemistry and you guys coming together. We just saw a really neat moment between the two teams, center court here. I know basketball on your mind right now, but also the world going through a lot right now. What did that mean to you guys to just go out there, and how has the team come through and come together during these unsettling times?
I mean, I think we're just blessed and happy to be out here trying to compete when, you know, a lot of countries around the world are shutting down again, lockdown, and we're just able to compete and play the sport that we love. So we're just blessed about it.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us. We wish you the best luck and hope to see you out there on Saturday. All right, GCU with their first game of the 2020-21 season in the books, and it was a victorious one, 69-53 over Grambling State. We'll be back here inside GCU Arena in just a few moments to wrap this one up. Don't go anywhere. We're still talking college hoops.
We can give you the mode to vibe out. Turn on tip-off mode to get game ready with uninterrupted radio on Pandora.
69-53, the final score and the debut of head coach Bryce Drew. And the first game for him, of course, in the GCU era, a successful one. Albeit we saw a little bit of everything, I guess, a first game would bring, right? Some of the issues at the free throw line, but that really improved in the second half. Got a little sloppy, some turnovers, but not maybe as high as maybe.
Welcome to the Xfinity Black Friday sales event. Welcome to 15 days of saving on fast, reliable internet and mobile with nationwide 5G on the most reliable network. Plus, learn how to save up to $500 with Xfinity Internet and Mobile. This sale won't last. Click, call, or visit a store today.
Ball club, I think they have some very good, talented players that know how to maximize their strengths while minimizing their weaknesses. 15 turnovers wasn't great, but I like the fact that they really got on the glass. They show a moxie that is impressive. The big fella, the big Ashty, mid guard, he does a nice job, obviously chewing glass with the 15 boards that you mentioned, the GCU High, we hadn't seen around here in a long time, and he plays outside of his space. You think a guy that big wouldn't be as mobile, but he's got some good mobility to him. You know, it was really nice to see Javon Blackshear, you know, go 36 minutes, get everybody involved, called his own number in the first half, and then you got Labor going in the second half. A lot of guys off that bench can contribute as well.
Speaking of Alessandro Labor, let's check out our Copper State Credit Union player of the game. 18 points, 8 rebounds, 6 of 8 from the field.
Yeah, he really turned it on in the second half, like we talked about. 14 of those 18 points coming in the second half. The 6 of 8 field goals. I like those high percentage shots. He knocked down the three. It was about his only outside shot. Then he, that little push along the baseline, and then smart enough to go back after it. That one was great because didn't settle for a little jump shot after the player went for the steal. Continued to put the pressure on the defense and hanging around the rim, getting those tip-ins. That's my favorite shot for Labor right there. When the ball's down on the wing or inside and comes back out and finds him on the outside and he knocks that down. If he can do that consistently, yeah. Lopes will be right there in that WAC championship contention again.
Javon Blackshear, 11 points, 7 assists in the game, and right from the opening jump. I mean, he has not showed, he definitely all the last season didn't show those freshman jitters. I mean, he's truly looking like a floor general right now.
He really does, and it seems as though the coaching staff has got the confidence in them already handed the keys to the bus and say, okay, you drive us where we want to go. Those 36 minutes, I love that steal he get and that play to Mikey Dixon. We saw that one at half. He had 3 steals in the game, and then this one, he just gets that catch and shoot, my favorite one right there, because he was waiting for Gabe to turn his head. He had to kind of hang in the air. It looked a little awkward, but finally put it on Gabe's chin where he's able to grab it and go put it in the basket. But just a real good player to have on a floor. I can't believe he's only a sophomore.
Incredible. It's going to be a lot of fun to see this team develop. Let's revisit our Sanderson Ford 3 keys to the game. Brought to you by Sanderson Ford. The best play in a new Ford is at Sanderson Ford.
Yeah, they got a little sloppy at times with the basketball. You expect that. 15 turnovers. We'd love to see it at 12, but 15 is not bad at all. And I think that they're going to, you know, some of those were because guys were a little out of place, throwing the ball where they thought guys would be, and they weren't. And then the commitment to defend, that was impressive. They hold a team to under 40% shooting and just crushed them on the glass, and you like that. And what you're starting to see, that all for one, one for all mentality of making the extra pass, coming back in, maybe getting a block shot when someone got out of position, getting excited when a teammate makes a good play, everybody up off the bench, meeting guys coming off the floor. Those are the kind of things that start to develop a chemistry that Coach Drew's going to want from his team when they have to get in tough scrapes, when the chips are against them on the road. They'll have that chemistry to be able to fight through those moments.
Now, as we are all experiencing dealing with COVID-19, the basketball world also is dealing with this. There is a game scheduled for Saturday. There was originally a game scheduled for Saturday. We hope there's a game played on Saturday. Right now, we are going through some protocols with an opponent. We hope to have definitive word, but we don't have it as of right now. So we encourage you to go to gculopes.com, the social media. The information will be pushed out to you to tune in and just keep it right here, right where you're watching on Saturday at about 6 p.m. Tip-off, 5:30. Kate will have the pregame show. Our fingers are crossed, much like yours are at home, as we deal with this. And this is, as we wrap things up here, this is great to see everybody, some familiar faces. We would love to have a packed arena, but, man, we needed this more than anything.
I'm thankful to have college basketball back. Looking for a great Thanksgiving tomorrow.
Yep, happy Thanksgiving
happy
to
Thanksgiving,
you.
Happy Thanksgiving,
partner. And happy Thanksgiving to you as well. That'll do it from GCU Arena, where tonight the Lopes are victorious. They beat the Tigers 69-53. Please join us again, perhaps on Saturday. Kate will have the pregame show at 5:30, tip-off scheduled for 6. But until then, for Kate Longworth, Scott Williams, and our entire crew, I'm Barry Beuchel, wishing you all a very wonderful Thanksgiving. Good night, everyone.